Hello friends, we'll be doing the chapter permutation and combination today, and we'll continue with the concepts of combinations today. We learned the various concepts of permutation, that is which was defined as the way, the number of ways in which certain elements can be arranged in a row. Similarly, combination is defined as basically choosing of certain elements out of the given set. That is, let us suppose if I say, in how many ways can you choose 5 boys out of a class of 10 boys? In how many ways can you do it? So this type of scenario is known as combination. That is, how many different types of combination of objects you can form. If I say AB and BA, these two are basically same in terms of combinations, because if I say, if you have to choose two boys from A, B, C, either you choose A and B or you choose B and A, they mean the same thing, because ideally both of them are present in that selection process, that both A and B are present over here as well, both A and B are present over here as well. So this type of scenario is known as basically combination. That is, you are choosing certain amount of elements given out of a set. So if I reconstruct the process of permutation, that is, let us suppose I was saying, you are given say 5 elements. Let us suppose you were given 5 elements and you have to arrange them in a row. Arrange say 3 of them in a row. So this is known as, according to the previous lecture, this is arranging 5 materials in 3, it is permuting 5 elements taken 3 at a time. So it would be NPR, that is 5P, 3, that is 5 factorial upon 5 minus 2 factorial, sorry, 5 minus 3 factorial, that would be 5 factorial upon 2 factorial. That would be 120 upon 2, that is 60. So if I say, this is basically saying that you, if I say arrange 3 of them out of these 5 in a row, in one way you can think it like this: you first select these 3 elements and then form different combinations of them. If I say there are 3 elements A, B, C, in how many ways you can choose 2 of them? If you just do it by normal counting method, that is, first you choose AB, or you can choose BC, or you can choose CA. So you have only 3 of these choices. That is, only in 3 ways you can choose this. But if I say you have to arrange, given these 3 elements, you have to permute them taken 2 at a time. That means you have to choose 2 of them and you have to arrange them in a row. So if you have to find permutations corresponding to them, you can say, I have chosen these 2 elements, now I would arrange them. So there would be 2 possibilities for AB. That is, A could be in front of B or B could be in front of A. Similarly for BC, there would be BC or CK. That is CB. That is, B in front of C or C in front of B. Similarly for CA, there would be CA and AC. That is, C in front of A and A in front of C. So for each of these combinations, that is, each of these criteria of choosing 2 elements, you have two ways of arranging that. So if I say you had a set of n elements, set of a1, a2, till an, this was a set of n element set, this was, and if I say choose r elements, so in how many ways can you do it? Let us suppose we say it is x. Okay, so let one combination of them was A1, A2, A3 till AR. We got one combination like this. That is, this is one of the possible combinations that you would get, that is choosing R elements. You chose one, A1, A2, A3 till AR. So if I say this is equivalent, if I form the permutations of it, if I had to just find out how many ways are there to permute R of these elements from this N set. So in that case, you would have counted this as A1, A2, A3, AR. This would have been equivalent to A1, A2, say, AR, AR minus 1. That is, you just change the last bits, and similarly all the possible combinations of these R elements. That is, in any way in which you would have arranged these R elements, that all belong to this set because they contain only these R elements. So corresponding to this one choice of R elements, you have R factorial permutations. That is, for any R values that you will choose, you can form R minus R factorial permutations. That is, you can arrange them in R factorial ways, and that would count in the total number of permutations that you can form by choosing, that is, permuting n elements taken R at a time. That would count into that. So for all of these x, that is, in all of these combinations of R elements, for each of them you would get corresponding R factorial permutations. So if I say that this x are the number of ways in which you can choose into R factorial, that is the number of permutations you can form from one of those chosen combination of R elements, you would get total number of permutations of n elements taken R at a time. So if I write this, it won't be wrong, because ideally whenever you are permuting n elements taken R at a time, you are first choosing the R elements which all you want to permute, and then you are making all the possible combinations of them. That is x, that was the total number of ways in which you could have chosen it, and into R factorial, that are the number of permutations that you can form by one such combination of R elements. That would result in the, all the possible permutations of n numbers taken R at a time. So this would give us x as, this would give us x as n factorial upon n minus R factorial by R factorial. So this is basically how many ways are there to choose R elements from given set of n elements. So this is basically the number of combinations, that is n factorial upon n minus R factorial into R factorial. So this quantity is basically known as combination. That is the number of ways to choose R elements from a given set of n elements. So this is this is basically what is written over here. This is the notation for it. This is the general notation for it. NCR, that is, N are the total number of elements you are choosing from. R is the number of elements you have chosen. And C denotes that you are taking the combination, that is, you are choosing the number. Or it is written like this. Curly brackets with R, N denoting the total number of elements that are there, and R is the total number of elements you are choosing. So this is equivalent to N factorial upon N minus R factorial upon R factorial. Or you can write the number of permutations of N elements taken R at a time divided by R factorial. So this is basically known as combination. Okay? So let us take another case. Let us suppose the elements were not distinct. So you could have taken them multiple times. As in, you can take more than one times any element. So I would consider the same example as we did earlier. There were three elements A, B, C. You have to choose two elements such that repetition is allowed. I would say first the three combinations that we did earlier would obviously come, because in them you are not repeating. So AB would come, BC would come, CA would come. Okay, in this there are no repetitions, and when repetition is allowed, you will get another three cases corresponding to repeating of these elements. So you get six cases corresponding to them. If you notice this carefully, first you are getting three elements, three cases. Now you are getting six elements. So the basic formula for this is, given n elements, number of ways to choose r elements when repetition is allowed. It is actually basically similar to something saying, if I had three more elements, say if I said like this, you had say, I would explain in a bit. First I would write the answer and then you would understand what I basically am saying. The number of ways to choose r elements when repetition is allowed from this given n elements is n plus r minus 1 cr. This is basically, you can understand it like this, if you had to choose r element and they could be repeated. So at max, let us suppose you had these a elements, a1, a2, a3, an. You had these elements. You had to choose r from them. If I say you can repeat those elements, isn't it similar to something if I say these can't be repeated, but you have something scenario like this. You have r more elements, you have r minus 1 more such elements, such that they are just, they have the same value, and let us suppose they have some different notation, that is a1 star, a2 star, like this. So they have some different notation. Now if we are, that is, we are just ignoring the fact that they are having the same value. If I say total there are r a1, but I am not just representing them by just one a1, I am just giving them different notations. Now if you had to choose from them, in how many ways could you have to? N plus r minus 1 cr, because there were total n plus r minus 1 elements, and now r you have to choose. In this case, all the r would be same, because you could have chosen this a1 and these r minus 1 a1 stars. So in this case, in like this, you can understand how this formula would have come, that is n plus r minus 1 cr. That is, you are choosing r elements from a set of, so you can verify this over here as well. Here n would be 3, because there are total 3 elements, and you are choosing 2 elements out of them, that is r equals 2. So the formula would be c2, that is 3 plus 2 minus 1, that is 4c2, 4 into 3 minus 3 upon 2, that is 6. So this gives us the answer, but we got by just enumerating. So we have just learned two basic formulas, that is, if you are given a set of n elements and you have to choose r from it, the basic formula is ncr, that is n factorial upon r, n minus r factorial by r factorial. And then you have to, when you are given n elements and you have to choose r from it where repetition is allowed, you can do it in n plus r minus 1 by cr ways. So I would like to do one or two properties of this factorial and combinations, so that you can do a bit of computation based on that. So we will begin in this part. These are basic things, but if you remember them, it would be nice, because it would, you won't need to calculate it again and again in the questions. So we'll begin with first thing, that is NC0 is 1. NC0 is 1, correct. Because you can see it is n factorial upon n minus 0 factorial. As you know, 0 factorial is 1. This is n factorial upon n factorial into 1. That is 1. Similarly, NCn is also 1. Because it would give you n factorial upon n minus n factorial into n factorial. That is n factorial upon 0 factorial into n factorial. So n factorial and n factorial will cancel out, this will be 1. Okay? Now third thing you must be remembering is, that is ncr upon ncr minus 1. What does that mean? This would be n factorial upon n minus r factorial upon r factorial, and here it will be n factorial upon n minus r minus 1 whole factorial into r minus 1 factorial. So if you club these denominator and numerator, this would go up and this would come down. So you would get n factorial into n minus r minus 1 factorial into r minus 1 factorial, and this denominator would be n minus r factorial into r factorial into n factorial. So n factorial and n factorial will cancel out. As you know, r minus 1 factorial is basically multiplication of all natural numbers from 1 to r minus 1. Similarly, r factorial would be multiplication of all natural numbers beginning from 1 to r. So this has just an r factor additional in it. Similarly, what does this say? Then you will overcome with this negative sign. So this would be n plus 1 minus r factorial. This would be n minus r. So what is this number? This is multiplication of all natural numbers beginning from 1 to n minus r. And this is multiplication of all natural numbers beginning from 0, sorry, beginning from 1 to n plus r minus 1. So this is basically 1 greater than this. So it would have cancelled out all its number excepting n plus 1 minus r. So this whole fraction would reduce down to n plus 1 minus r upon r. Okay, so this is a three basic formulas we have derived. This one you might not remember, but you know how to figure it out. If you can remember, it is pretty good, because you can directly put this value over here and you can get this value. So if I say you have to find say 10c5 upon 10c4, you don't need to calculate 10c5 first and then divide by 10c4. If you directly put it over here, this would be 10 plus 1 minus r. That is, remember the top one is r. So this would be 10 plus 1 minus 5 upon r. That is 5. That is 11 minus 5. That is 6 upon 5. So you can directly do it. You don't need to basically calculate 10c5 first and 10c4 again and then divide these two and cancel out with fractions, these with fractions and decimals. You don't have to do that. You have to just remember this formula and directly put the values. Okay? So these three basic formulas would be clear to you. I would do one or two formulas more. One more basic formula is about, say, fourth property is NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equivalent to N plus 1 CR. So this is basically, you can check this, this is the proof of it. First numerator is first combination, that is N factorial upon N minus R factorial into R factorial, plus this is N factorial upon n minus r minus 1 whole factorial into r minus 1 factorial. What would be it? So if you take the LCM of these two, okay, what does taking the LCM means? LCM means you have to find the least common multiple of it. Least common multiple of both these are, if you have any common factor, just take it out, and whatever that remains, you have to multiply these. So if we take the common factors of these two, this is a multiply, this would be n plus 1 minus r. Okay. So if I take the common factors of these, what would be it? This is the multiplication of all the numbers from 1 to r minus 1. This is the multiplication of all numbers from 1 to r. So basically, there you can figure out their common factor would be multiplication of all the natural numbers from 1 to r minus 1. Similarly, this is multiplication of all numbers from 1 to n minus r. This is multiplication of all natural numbers from 1 to n plus r, n plus 1 minus r. So the common factor would be multiplication of all natural numbers from 1 to n minus r. So this is basically their HCF. So this would be multiplied with the common, the factors that remain in both these. So here the factor would be remaining is n plus 1 minus r, and here the factor would be remaining is r. So what would be the LCM over here? As you can see, r would be multiplied over here, so it would become r factorial, and here this n plus 1 minus r would be multiplied with n minus r, so it would give us n plus 1 minus r factorial. So you can remember this directly as well. Whichever the factor that is greater over here, in any of these two fractions, that would come over here. That is, in here, if you compare these two, r factorial was greater than r minus 1 factorial, so you get r minus 1 factorial over here. Here n plus 1 minus r factorial was greater, so you would get n plus 1 minus r factorial. This you can do directly because here you are dealing with multiplications, not with additions. So here it is a combination of all multiples from 1 to all those numbers. So you can do it directly. So if you either divide this LCM by this fraction, what would be the fraction you will be getting? That is, r and r factorial is the same. This is multiplication of all natural numbers from 1 to n minus r. This is from 1 to n plus 1 minus r. So what we would get is n plus 1 minus r, the factor remaining, into n factorial plus n factorial into, what is the factor when we divide this by this? N plus 1 minus r factorial is same over here. Here it is r minus 1 factorial, here it is r. So you multiply it with r. So what would you get in the denominator if you take n factorial common? This would be n plus 1 minus r plus r upon r factorial into n plus 1 minus r factorial. So r and r would be cancelled out. So this is n factorial into n plus 1. That is the multiplication of all natural numbers from till n, and this is multiplied to n plus 1. So it would be multiplication of all natural numbers till n plus 1. So it would be n plus 1 factorial. Similarly, the denominator fraction would be n factorial plus n plus 1 minus r factorial. Don't you think this is something similar to what this fraction looks like? This fraction is basically n plus 1 factorial upon n plus 1 minus r factorial into r factorial. This is basically same as this thing. So we have just now proved this, that you just remember this theorem, that is ncr plus ncr minus 1 gives us n plus 1 cr. So if I say you have to do this, nc4 plus nc3, you don't need to do it directly. You don't need to calculate nc4 first and nc3 first and then calculate. You can do it directly. This is n value is over here is 10, r value is 3. Just remember that the greater one is r, okay, and the top value, that is n value, should be same. So it would give us n plus 1 c, n plus 1 cr, that is 11c4. So you can directly calculate 11c4 rather than calculating two combinations and then adding them. You can do it directly. So these are the basic four properties, or you can say formulas, for combinations. So in this lecture we learned what is basically combination and what is meant by the different type of combination, that is choosing r values from a given set of n values where repetition is allowed, and we learned about 3-4 properties of combination. Rest we will do some questions on combinations etc. in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.